Hi guys, this is Ancestral Owl Messages, and this is going to be Full Moon in Libra read for the collective sign of Capricorn. Okay, before we get into the details of the read, let's pray. Great Creator, Father God, Divine Mother, Mother Mary, Angels, Ancestors, and Spirit Guides, I just pray and ask for wisdom and clarity and for any messages that need to come through for the collective sign of Capricorn for this, their Full Moon in Libra read, March 28th. To April 2nd, we'll say. In Jesus' name, amen. The energy of this full moon is going to kind of linger for a minute. It was very emotional in the first few days before the full moon. So, one more shuffle. Personal issue reaches resolution. Full moon in Cancer. And luck is on your side. New moon in Sagittarius. I'm thinking something's happening here, Capricorn. And you could, this could be your own beginning of a cycle here. That, excuse me. That may not find the resolution or you may not see the results of it until the new moon in Aries. New moon in Aries is supposed to be April 12th. Okay, so that was the Moonology deck by Yasmin Boland. This is Angels and Ancestors deck by Kyle Gray. So let's get a few cards here. So, Capricorn. Elder, move beyond ancestral patterns. I love this card because this talks about healing your ancestral line, tapping into your DNA, programming. This is healing things in your family line that you may not even be aware of. But by making different choices than previous generations, you're really putting a stop to the same patterns repeating itself. Star Ancestor, follow the voice of your soul. I love it. Star Seeds. We are all products of the stars. Not products of the stars, but we have that energy within us. Excuse me. Okay, one more. Trader, exchange energy to create abundance. This talks about instead of being preoccupied with those things that no longer serve you, put your energy into those things that see abundance is emotional fulfillment, mental fulfillment, spiritual fulfillment. Abundance isn't just money. Abundance is more than that. It's put your energy towards those things that bring you peace. That's where you receive your abundance. And I love that it's Star Ancestor, follow the voice of your soul. This is basically remember who you are. Remember who you are. And one more, you can get it. Summer, bask in joy and light. Capricorn. Awesome, 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 awesome. Let's go to the Mystical Moments Oracle deck. And then we'll pull a few tarot mystical moments to go a little bit deeper. All right, here we go. Morning Dew Girl 13. And I'm going to read these two. I cannot do this deck justice. The artwork is just beautiful. The cards are really profound. And Abracadabra 34. 3 and 4 is 7. That is number of creation. 1 and 3 is 4. That's number of stability. Okay, let's do 13, 4. 13 first. 13. Morning Dew Girl. Face your fears, awareness, consciousness. The woman on this card collects fat raindrops into a basket of leaves. She is called Morning Dew Girl, and she symbolizes the receiving and absorption of all worries and fears. She invites us to start sharing our own feelings and worries. We can collect with them and deal with them instead of hiding them deep inside. She stands resolute and strong, ready to face her fears. While fear can be as powerful as a river, once confronted, it may turn out to be as small as a drop of dew. I love it. And we got Abracadabra, number 34 card. Magic, secrets, patterns, destiny. Rising from a kingdom of skyscrapers, a giant woman glows in the cityscape. She is so tall she can touch the stars all around her. With her magic wand, she coaxes the future from the constellations. There you go, star ancestor. There is such order in the universe in the golden ratio of a nautilus shell or patterns in the starry night. We can unlock the secrets of the universe. We are all magicians of our own lives. Like I said, this is remembering who you are. Let's go to the tarot, which is also magical. Is it Mystical Moments? Mystical Moments by Katrine Wildstein. Yeah, I feel like the personal issue, I feel like your attention has been on that personal issue. And maybe by looking at it and focusing on it and worrying about it, nothing seems to be happening. But the moment that you release it and give the personal issue to a higher power and just really open yourself to receive, then that's when you're going to get the resolution. Death card. First card out. Queen of Cups. Queen of Swords. Three of Cups. Excuse me. These are two different people. Usually, and you got Strength card. Usually, like, when... And I'll say this before I continue on here. Usually when you get, like, kings or queens, it's usually your energy and it's different. Because we can step into the energy. There's no gender in tarot. This is, we can step into that Piscean energy. We can step into, it'd be Aquarian energy, maybe? Air sign? But we can step into that by the different choices that we make and by the way we approach something and by the way we see a situation, we can do that. But here, and sometimes it'll really show up to where this is an energy that's outside you, but it's affecting you and that's why it shows up. These are two different people. So these are two different energies embodied in two different people. If that makes sense. Like, those are separate energies, and they're not your own. Then you have Knight of Swords. Three of Wands. Another three card here. Ten of Cups. Underneath the Queen of Swords card. Uh-huh. Emperor. Aries. That is your energy. Wheel of Fortune. Okay. Death card. This is transformation. This transformative energy. And I feel like this happened because. Like, when you do the... When you see the death card and you see where it's transformation, this is change. This is something happening to where... I want to say, like, it almost turns you to, like, a 180. It just brings about this different person out of you. Or it changes something within you to where it's, like, something clicks. and there's a growth. Like, you're emerging from a cocoon, like, immediately going into a cocoon and then coming out as the butterfly. Like, you go through this transformation, and you, like, things happening in your life will bring about that transformation, will bring about that change. Excuse me. Relationships ending will bring about that change. Relationships beginning will bring about that change. Friendships, jobs. There's many things that bring about this change. Now, what I feel like brought about that change, Queen of Cups, Queen of Swords. Like I said, there's no gender in tarot. These are two different people. One is coming across as a very, I won't say emotional based, but someone that reacts, that, there you go, reacts out of their emotions. Then you have someone that, thinker, and acts out of their actions. Risk taker. So you have two different energies here. Excuse me. So you have someone that their steps are tempered. I wouldn't say tempered, but guided by their emotions. You need to have someone else in your life where risk taker. They're in their head. It's like an idea. They come up with ideas, but they want to see them through and they put them into action. It's very, they're a thinker. Like, they're always in their head. So these two different energies happening. This is what brought about this change because of what follows with these two. Excuse me. I get a tickle in my throat here. You have Three of Cups, Strength, and Knight of Swords. Third parties, and I want to talk about this. Third parties can be anything. This can be gossip. This could be anything. Job, family, friends, coworkers. The definition of a third party energy is any outside force that becomes emotionally involved in your emotional connection is categorized as a third party energy. This is what happened. This is what I feel like happened. These two could have been friends of yours. This could be friends of yours. There could be, because you can also have that energy too. And I feel like it's like friends. Usually when there's three friends, and this isn't all the time, but when you have a dynamic of three, then there's, it's not like this, how do I put this? It's not like a, you have three different people who are coming together, sharing time with one another. There's always going to be a dynamic of one leading or, and another one basically battling for control. Oftentimes that's what happens. I feel like this is what happened here, where it was a union of three and one was vying for control over the other one. Like, it's like a power struggle type of thing. And there was a, I feel like there's betrayal here. I feel like there was betrayal here. Because I feel like this is what this is. And it was an outside interference to where you needed strength to continue on. When this strength card shows up, it's an impartation of strength when you've run out of your own. Now, in order to, when you get to this place where you need strength just to face this, that's what's going on. This is why I grabbed all three of those cards, because this leads to this, which is Knight of Swords, taking divisive action. Moving forward. Now, you go from Three of Cups to having to do this damage control with these two to Three of Wands. And I feel like this is the conversation between you and these two people. I do. This could have been a dynamic where it was something went awry here. But I feel like with the energy of this full moon, if it happened before then, this is what's going to happen. And this is Three of Wands. This is reconnecting and all three talking about it. There's a light side to this card and dark side to this, or a shadow side to this card. The shadow side to Three of Wands, because wands are words. When you do three, this is God, man, the angels, it's number of divinity, Father, Son, Holy Ghost. But when it comes to three, you're talking about three people talking. This could be me talking to someone, then me not understanding what they had said and going to someone for advice and saying, they said this, what did that mean? That is the light side of it, as well as having a conversation where the three people are involved in this conversation. Texting, social media, something. But it's a unity of words, three people's words. That's why it's Three of Wands. Four of Wands, you go into the stability of home because four represents, how was it described? And I love this, Jeanette Napolitano. I absolutely adore her. Four legs of a chair, four walls to a house, that type of thing. That's the stability of home. So it's still words. It's like planning out. This is what I want happening. So when you do the Three of Wands, this is three people conversing. The shadow side of it is talking to someone and having your words being twisted and being talked about and gossip going this way. So, I mean, I feel like this is a rejoining of the three of you. Like, if it's a friend scenario, I feel like that's what's happening. Because you removed yourself from this, and then this then now is a reconnection of the three. That's one scenario. The other scenario, if I'm talking, like I could be talking in two different groups of people. The other scenario is that this whole little chapter here has been in the past and you have something else coming. So the chapter here being Three of Cups, which is third party, and then this needing the strength and having to fight to move forward and really making that decisive action, and this being also a part of this third party where texting, and because this is also texting, and this being a chapter that has closed, and that what is coming your way is this Ten of Cups. Ten of Cups is emotional fulfillment. This is happiness, joy, finding, almost like finding your missing link type of thing, like for you, like missing piece of your heart, missing piece of, but you can also be in the Ten of Cups energy by yourself. Be fulfilled on your own. But I feel like this is someone else coming in. But this is your energy, which is the Emperor. And I feel like you're embodying this energy, stepping into this energy. The Emperor is the embodiment of all four kings. This is someone that's got their shit together, understands what's going on. I'm not going to basically be a like doormat for anyone. I demand more. And if I demand more, I'm going to be more for people. That this is what the Emperor energy is. And see, I like this. If this is something that's happened and the chapter has closed and this is what you've walked away from, this is what's coming. If this hasn't happened yet, then it's like this is going to be a swift, fast-moving transformation, because it's going to be one of those things of, oh, is that what's really happening? I got stuff to do. I'm going that way. Because this is emotional fulfillment, really taking charge of your life and demanding more, but demanding more of yourself. Then you got Wheel of Fortune energy, which is luck. This is destiny. This is fate. And with these three, this is like new love coming in, but this is also being satisfied and whole and emotionally fulfilled within yourself. And I feel like this is your energy. But these three is the, basically, not the last chapter, but it's almost like the resolution of this. Like, this had to happen to get here. That's what I'm trying to say. All right, so let's pull Mists of Avalon. Okay, the White Spring. Protection, healing, gratitude, energy. Number 5 card, number of change, protection. Absolutely love it. Healing, gratitude, energy, and protection. One more. The Dragon, strength, power, integration, and pathfinder. Strength. Going back to that word. Number 13 card, 1 and 3 is 4. Number of stability. So you got change and stability, energy and strength. Last deck. Okay, here we go. And I love the how they have the two dragons. Was that red and white? Very passionate and very protective, pure. Purified, what is it? Christ-like. There we go. Shuffle them a lot better. This is Magical Times Empowerment card deck. Alright, last one. Get you two more cards here, Capricorn. Manifestation. Your dreams have untold energy. Open the door and let them live. Desire and belief are your power. Say it like this because, okay, look. You're breaking ancestral patterns. These two people could be family members. It could be family members. That there's a dynamic there where they've put you in a position where it's just incredibly, like, off kilter, or something's not right. But remember, see, the traitor card is that manifestation. Just remember who you are. You are more powerful than what you believe. Faith, believe you are not alone. Spirit is right beside you. Ask for guidance and it will come. Your spirit team, spirit guides, angels, ancestors are there waiting for you to ask them for assistance. Okay, so for the collective sign of Capricorn, this is your full moon in Libra read. Excuse me, love and light.